Two of them. I have two wallpapers for you this weekend. Who loves you the best, baby? I believe it is accurate to say that the second generation GDGG Subaru WRX is one of the better examples of these wonderful machines. Don't get me wrong. The newer ones are faster and more comfortable and more high-tech and modern. But the WRX from the early and mid-2000s, the first WRX to come to America, really nailed that street-legal rally car feel that you just don't quite get anymore. It is a good car. And photographer Eric Schaffhauser would know. This is his 2006 WRX Wagon and he's clearly taken it to some interesting places. You can see more of his work on Facebook and Instagram. And you should, because it's good stuff. Hit the expand symbol on the top left of these pics for full wallpaper-sized versions. Happy trails!
Subaru South Africa has launched its new Impreza and XV in the earlier in 2017. Recently, Wheels 24 had the latter on test to find out what the second-generation high-riding crossover is like to drive on our roads. The all-wheel drive XV 2.0 ISES CVT retails for R439,000 and is fitted standard with cornering headlights, keyless entry and push-button ignition, a 20cm touchscreen infotainment system which includes sat-nav. You can also easily link your iPhone or Android device. The cabin is a great environment to be in. Comfortable, heated, seats do a great job of keeping the occupants ensconced in comfort. It's spacious, filled with storage binnacles and even features a sunroof that makes the cabin feel even more airy. Good quality materials are used in the dark colored cabin, while smatterings of chrome add an upmarket touch. A host of safety features bandied together, which Subaru calls EyeSight, sees the car detect when objects, cars or pedestrians, are in your blind spot. On, rear cross-traffic alert in front and rear parking sensors. There's also adaptive cruise control. The car will warn you if you're drifting out of your lane and will even automatically apply the brakes if it feels you're distracted or getting too close too quickly to a vehicle ahead. The XV is powered by a gutsy 2.0-liter normally aspirated engine with direct injection which according to the automaker is 12 kilograms less than the previous engine used in the SUV. It produces a modest 115 kilowatts and 196 newton meters and is mated to a continuous variable transmission (CVT) that does an okay job of swapping through the infinite gears. Subaru says the gearbox is just shy of 8 kilograms lighter than the previous CVT. Some CVTs, in fact most, can feel as if they're slipping but the team admittedly felt the XV's transmission performed admirably. We averaged around 7.8 L/100 km during our fortnight test with most of the distance covered in the city. Subaru claims the 2.0-liter engine uses 7.1 L/100 km. It drives well with light steering albeit lacking in feedback. But then again it's not meant for the enthusiastic driver. The ride quality however is extremely composed in its application. The XV shows off its off-road characteristics with roof rails, standard, and black cladding on the wheel arches. Subaru quotes a 220mm ground clearance which gives the hatchback a decent stance in traffic. Practically it means you won't have to worry about hitting the middle monette when venturing off the beaten track. Its rugged appearance perhaps doesn't justify the smoothness of the car when driven in the city. At just shy of R440,000, the XV makes a compelling argument for a family looking for a vehicle that does a wonderful job of blending into a city slicker and able to tackle the beaten track. It offers a spacious package complete with a host of safety features. Subaru owners tend to retain their vehicles for a long period and it makes sense when the XV is offered with a 5-year or 150,000 km warranty as well as a 3-year or 75,000 km maintenance plan.
Nissan has been testing different vehicle-to-grid, V2G, systems, which enable electric car owners to use their car's battery pack to feed energy back into their home or grid, with the Leaf for years now. With the launch of the next generation Leaf, Nissan now unveils a new EV ecosystem, including a scheme to offer free power to owners with the V2G system. Since Tesla launched the Powerwall, its home battery pack, in 2015, several other automakers have launched similar products leveraging their electric car battery pack development. Mercedes-Benz launched its battery pack earlier this year, just like Renault earlier this summer, but Nissan's entry in the market is a little different. Nissan's home battery pack, called X-Storage, also serves as an electric car wall connector, and it's bi-directional, meaning that it can take energy from the car's battery pack and feed it to the unit, power the house, or send it through the electric grid. Nissan says that the home battery pack, which was developed in partnership with Eaton, has sold more than 1,000 units across Europe in just 3 months, with 5,000 units expected to be sold by the end of March 2018. Nissan expects to sell 100,000 home energy units by the end of FY 2020 in Europe. Using what they learned from test programs with those packs, including a trial with a fleet in Denmark last year, Nissan announced a plan to offer customers free power for its EVs. Using Nissan bi-directional charging, customers can draw energy from the grid to power their car or van and then sell back to the grid for others to use. This means, once a nominal charge has been paid by the business for the installation of a V2G charger, there are no fuel or energy costs. Just free power for your EV. Of course, this plan is highly dependent on market conditions, especially local electricity rates and time-of-use billing schemes. They are launching a similar program in the UK with OVO, and they are exploring other regions in Europe to offer similar programs. Paul Wilcox, chairman of Nissan Europe, said about the announcement in an event in Norway yesterday. "Step by step, we are removing any barriers to electric vehicle adoption, from infrastructure investment, to how people access the power itself. Over the coming decades, through our Nissan Intelligent Mobility Vision, the electric ecosystem will transform modern life as we know it. But while the starting point for it is 100% electric vehicles like the new Leaf and ENV200, the impact goes much further. With fewer emissions, our cities and air will be cleaner. With more intelligent safety features, car accidents would be reduced dramatically. With better connections between vehicles and their surroundings, the school run or daily commute will no longer be clogged with traffic. And by letting people charge their vehicle in their home from each other, we can use our time and energy supplies more efficiently than ever." He also announced that Nissan plans to support the deployment of 1,000 fast chargers, CHAdeMO, in Europe over the next 18 months. Electric's take: vehicle to grid is a very attractive additional feature to have on an electric vehicle, but it has some drawbacks. For example, if someone is actually looking for a permanent home energy storage solution, it's just not it. You can't count on your car being available with enough energy capacity to serve as home energy storage all the time. That's where Nissan's solution is especially interesting, since its car's V2G system is actually combined with a home battery pack, which enables always some capacity at home. For backup power, especially in prolonged power outages, it's an interesting solution, but it's another matter for daily cycling when combined with solar energy or for grid services, which is another drawback. Long-range electric vehicle battery packs are optimized, or at least they should be, for weekly cycling. You can top the car off every night, but generally speaking, a full charge lasts a few days to a week for regular commuting. A home battery pack combined with a solar installation or to use for grid services cycles every day. Doing this with an electric car battery pack puts an additional strain on it that could accelerate its degradation. In short, it's a cool feature to have, but there are a few things to keep in mind.